Hello everybody, my name is Zohir Chaudhry, and right now we'll talk about alpha, beta, gamma, and X-rays, these types of ionizing radiation. So there are various types of ionizing radiation, alpha, beta, gamma, X-rays, as well as neutron from fission. So in here, when we say about radiation, we can mention alpha radiation or alpha particle, what comes out from this radiation process, beta particle or beta radiation, as well as gamma rays and X-rays, or radiation from gamma and radiation from X-rays. So what is alpha particle? Alpha particle essentially has two neutrons and two protons. Two neutrons, for example, these black ones, and two protons, these white ones, for example, that is ejected from the nucleus. So as a result, the radioactive isotope that is ejecting an alpha particle will have this four particle less from its nucleus and will be lighter. And it is definitely slow-moving and non-penetrating because this is pretty heavy in general with respect to particles. On the other hand, beta particles, it's much lighter. It's a small neutron that is turning itself into a proton, and as it turns the neutrons into a proton, it ejects an electron in this process. And beta radiation occurs when the ratio of neutrons to protons in the nucleus is too high. In this case, an excess neutron transforms into a proton and an electron. The proton stays in the nucleus and the electron is ejected. Energetically, beta particle is identical to an electron. Gamma rays and X-rays are essentially not similar to alpha and beta. It's electromagnetic energy that is released from an agitated nucleus. Neutrons from fission, which is a less talked thing, because neutrons are mostly released by nuclear fission, the splitting of atoms in a nuclear reactor, and hence are seldom encountered outside the core of a nuclear reactor. Thus, they are not normally a problem outside nuclear plants. And this process is showing like a neutron being coming in, bombarding radioactive isotopes, thus splitting it, and then more neutrons are released in this process, which can cause a chain reaction in a nuclear reactor. This chart shows the type of ionizing radiation and their penetration ability. Alpha, as we saw earlier, it's a particle that is pretty big and heavy. As a result, it falls down pretty fast, and also because of its size, it's unable to penetrate through a sheet of paper, can be stopped very easily, and also the skin of a person can stop alpha particle. Beta particle, on the other hand, can be stopped by a layer of clothing or by a few millimeter of a substance such as aluminum. Be careful when we talk about clothing. Even though clothing can act as a barrier, however, clothing is still very porous, so beta particle can potentially also harm people through the pore of the clothing, depending on what type of clothing you're wearing. Exposed skin can be damaged through beta particle. As a result, you'll experience radiation burn from beta particle exposure. On the other hand, gamma rays can be stopped by only several feet of concrete or a few inches of lead, because gamma rays can actually go through our tissue very easily. Main sources of alpha radiation are coming from uranium mining waste, as well as mining and other method that processes fertilizer ores. Usage of alpha radiation is, for example, radium-226 is used for treating cancer. Polonium-210 is used to eliminate static electricity in paper mills and other industry. Americium-241 is used in smoke detectors, especially smoke detectors that have two chambers in them. It's a sealed source, though. Health effects of ionizing radiation. Typically, it's a problem when you have internal exposure. So external exposure, which is external to the body, is a far less concern when it comes to alpha particle, because alpha particle doesn't have enough energy to penetrate through the dead layer of the skin. However, if alpha particle goes internally in your body, at that time it can cause havoc, because the radiation internally can start causing serious health effects. Alpha radiation can also penetrate if you have wounds or, for example, your eyes. If you don't have proper eye protection, it can cause damage to your eye and go inside your body through the wounds. Inhalation and ingestion are also concerned with alpha particle. So contaminated food can be a problem. Air that is full of alpha particle, if you're breathing that air, that can also cause problem if you're very near the source. So alpha particle can penetrate the skin, causes internal hazard, can be stopped by a piece of paper, and it's found in soil, radon, and other radioactive materials. Beta particle. Main source of beta particles, it's mostly medical imaging, diagnostic, and other treatment procedure, as well as iodine-131 can be used in nuclear reactor as well. And as a result of accidents, it can be released into the food chain, into the environment. And also several industrial instrument can use beta radiation for its work. In terms of uses, ionizing 131, it is used to treat thyroid disorders. Phosphorus 32 is used in molecular biology and genetic research. Strontium 90 is used as a radioactive tracer in medical and agricultural studies. And carbon 14, as many of you may know, is used for dating organic matter. So we can understand how far rock is coming, how old a rock is by analyzing carbon 14. Health effects, essentially inhalation and ingestion, both of them are of great concern. From an outside perspective, if it gets deposited on your skin tissue, it can cause skin burns. So that's a main problem as well. So both external and internal problem are a concern. So it can cause skin, eye, and internal hazards, stopped by thin piece of sheet of plastic, and naturally occurring, but also it occurs in man-made reactors. And finally, X-rays and gamma rays, as we saw, these are the ones that are the most penetrating. They can be stopped by lead as well as thick layer of concrete. They have tremendous uses in medicine, and they are present in natural soil and also as in cosmic radiation. Let's do some quick concept check. And actually, we have quite a few this time. Which of the following terms can be used to describe an unstable atom? A, radioactive. Which type of radiation has the greatest penetrating power? C, gamma. Very good. The type of radiation which is only a hazard if it originates from radioactive material inside the body is alpha. Be careful how this is worded. It's saying that external, it doesn't cause problem, but internal, yes, whereas the other one will cause both internal and external hazard. Alpha, it's mostly an internal hazard. The question here is reversed. The type of radiation which presents the greatest hazard from radioactive materials outside the body is gamma. The type of radiation which may cause skin burns if it originates from radioactive material located on the skin for extended period of time is beta. Very good. Thank you.